goods.
It's as good as it's gonna get. Steering wheel cutting off faces. So.
Yeah.
We have been out of commission. No, just kidding. I mean, not kidding, because we have been, but.
I'm barely living.
Still have been doing stuff. Getting stuff done.
If there was a metric for an organism's life, something.
You're thriving still. You're thriving. Don't let him.
See? That's what I'm saying. I can't even complete a thought. It was like, and then it retracted inside of its hole of thought.
Do we want to talk about the house stuff?
Yeah, sure. So, the house that actually was right over here that we terminated the contract on after our offer was accepted, there were some findings. And
so we got the inspection.
The home inspection.
So the order of things, if you don't know, with buying a house is you find a house you like, you send in an offer. And then, well, what happened with this house is that they didn't accept our first offer. They didn't even counter offer. They just were flat out no. And we found out that it was like a 3-person trust, so probably 3 kids trying to decide what to do with mom's house or whatever. But we really loved this house because of the location, which we're about to pass. Actually, we could film a little bit of it.
Yeah.
Reed College is right here.
Nice.
4 blocks away, 5 blocks away.
And we can count the blocks.
Which is like, you know, it's Oregon's prestigious college. It's liberal, but it's still like, you know, Steve Jobs went there, so it has a reputation.
And he dropped out.
And he dropped out.
As a statement. Here, you want to film this?
Yeah. The area.
So this is Woodstock going down.
We're going west, down Woodstock. Downtown. When you're alone and life is making you alone. And
so this is the beginning.
Start of the campus. So, yeah.
This is 4 blocks away.
The area, the location. Then there's like $1 million homes across the street. The house that we were looking at was 600 square feet. So it was very tiny. Look at how pretty this is. This is like the quintessential college campus that you think of when you think you see movies of college. My college campus was not like this.
I went to a freshly built community college.
Look at how pretty and picturesque. Kind of looks haunted, actually.
Gorgeous.
Like Dead Poet Society. That's what I picture. Anyways. Oh, and then there's like $1 million house. $3 million house.
Yeah, exactly. It's bigger than our house. That chimney alone is larger than our house.
So, we love the house. And for our like first flip to rental house, we thought it would be a good idea to have something smaller.
Right, because it's less square footage to have to remodel.
Sorry about that, guys. Dropped ya. Going through the curvies.
Whoopsie daisy.
The curves. There's a golf course right here. Yes. And it's only like 4 minutes away from our house. So we fell in love with it. I had like devoted a lot of time into like getting materials to remodel it because we wanted to make that fast. And like
not actually getting materials.
No, but like finding
I was
prices.
Like, you got materials?
Finding prices and
we had basically done all the groundwork so that when we bought it, we were ready to move on it as far as everything that needed to be done.
So we waited a month after the first couple offers they turned down without countering. It had been on the market for 6 months, so now we're going on 7 months. We resubmitted another offer, and then
a little bit higher.
We got into contract.
They accepted.
And so we were like, yeah! inspection because there was no inspection done yet of this house. Which
so then we had a 10-day inspection period, which is pretty common.
So yeah, so you have 10 days to get the inspection done. You have to pay for the inspector.
You provide a earnest money deposit, which is basically money that commits your offer on the home. And
there's a coyote right there.
If for whatever reason you don't do your due diligence in that time,
there's like a fox coyote.
You can lose that deposit. You know, it's $2,500, so.
So you want to be on it.
You want to know whether you're going to follow through or terminate the contract.
So we got the inspection. The inspector, you know, the house is old, like 1917.
1916, something like that.
So almost 100 years old, or a little over 100 years old,
yeah.
And then he liked the house. There wasn't anything super major except for that they couldn't get under the house. There was no crawl space.
There wasn't anything super major at first.
Yeah, at first. Well, with that inspector, there wasn't.
Exactly. Well, he was like, well, we thought there was a point in the crawl space and where we could access, and it wasn't. And the floor was just like, the subflooring was damp.
Which means that there wasn't proper
There was
drainage.
Moisture coming from underneath. Oop. Which signaled to...
Oop. Post office, it's full. It's
crack-a-lackin' in here.
Yes, you can park right there.
Oh wait, this person's leaving. Oh,
okay. And so then, not getting under the house was kind of an issue, and our realtor contacted the selling agent and was like, hey, we need to get under this house before we, you know, keep going through with this deal, because
we need to see why there's so much moisture under there.
Right, and you need permission to, like,
do any kind of, you know, opening up of floors and whatnot.
So then the sewer scope guy showed up.
Sewer scope guy.
Which we almost canceled because we were like, well, we still need time. We need to extend the time to be able to get under the house to see what's going on.
Anyway, so. But he showed up and, you know, he kind of just went about his business. And I was talking with the home inspector outside.
Who we really liked.
And then the sewer guy came up. He's like, well, I got some bad news for
you.
Which was a relief, because when there's something material about the house that is being revealed to you, it's good news. More like, the more information you have is always better.
Up front is like the less before you buy it.
I should clarify that. Before you buy it, more information's better. After you buy it, you're like, la 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 la. He was like, yeah, we'll upload the video so you can watch it. But essentially, as soon as I transitioned, like the scope transitioned from iron pipe to concrete,
like outside of the house,
it was collapsed. And
he couldn't get through.
He was just like hitting soil. So he couldn't even see where the sewer line went from there.
And how much damage was done.
Exactly. So
he did say that, like, right outside of where it measured to, right outside of the house was...
Holes in the ground?
Holes in the ground.
Yeah.
Rat holes.
Rat holes!
I guess is a big thing. Rats like to...
Nibble.
Eat through concrete and get into your sewers. And they that's probably
that
why there's a rat in Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles that lives in the sewers.
I mean, there's a lot of good stuff down in the sewers. Like, if there wasn't so much doo-doo, I'd probably be down just scoping out.
So either...
What kind of stuff?
Well, the pipes were running underneath the house. We don't know how long it's been unoccupied for, so there wasn't, like, a smell or anything, which is nice. But because the property's old, there's not updated sewer line... where the sewer line is coming from, so then they thought that potentially it could be run off of, which doesn't make sense because that little house is there first. But it might be ran off of the house next door to it, because it's like on one lot, kind of.
Called a party line.
And then you would have to get permission from them to fix it. So that came back to us to be like, what are we going to do?
I did one of these.
But really, it was on the sellers to, because the property was not, like, he said it was uninhabitable,
yeah.
Which means can't be sold as a conventional loan if you can't live in it. Okay. And it's, the city has to fix the sewer, so it was really on the seller to fix the problem. And we thought for sure they were going to be like, nope, we're not going to do that.
Yeah.
Either the deal's on or the deal's off. But they were like, we're going to look into our people and see what we can come up with. And we waited.
Yeah, basically.
And
they said that they were going to provide an extension in the inspection period so that it wouldn't expire. And they never got back to us, so.
And you didn't want to lose your earnest money.
And I wasn't trying to just give them my earnest money deposit, so we terminated the contract like the day before.
So
then that one was a wash, okay?
So that's what happened.
Moving past that one. Since then, we've looked at, what, two other houses?
Mm-hmm.
One was a really good prospect in the photos until we walked into the OJ scene on the floor and...
What?
Windows on, like, pulley system. Like, all the electrical coming out of... The breaker box in the house snipped. Someone had scavenged all the copper wire. So I was like, nope, not getting into that. And no, so, thank you.
But here's some advice I'd like to give to you guys who are, if you guys are doing a similar thing, or just home buying in general. You can't really fall in love with the thing, with the property. Like, don't invest too much energy and time into it until you know for sure that it's yours. Because I feel like I get really invested and then I'm spending a lot of time taking measurements, trying to see like how much the flooring's going to be to change it, how much all of the things that need to be updated. I get like into like this zone where, and then I like start to like hunch over the computer and I'm like, oh, my shoulders are hurting and like I can't sleep because all I'm thinking about is redoing this house. And you just like can't.
I think it just gets easier with time though too.
It's because... like a breakup. I felt like I broke up with the place.
And that's the thing, is it's good to fall in love with everything, and the breakup is gonna get
let
easier.
It go, let it go.
The breakup gets easier every time.
Anyway, so that's our updated. We don't have a house.
Yeah. So this most recent one, I submitted an offer, and it was priced at $270. I was like, I want to offer $250, and then my agent was like, there's 9 other offers. I was like, okay, so maybe $260, and she's like, yeah, there's offers at the asking price. I was like,
it's probably going for more than the asking price.
Then it's not gonna happen. But I offered $260, but the bank didn't even look at it. They just let the offer expire. So
I loved that house too, though. That one was triple the size of that little house. And I was like, how are we gonna do this? But we would.
It was closer to 2,000 square feet. It was on a 70 by 100 lot, which is a big lot.
The brain is fried.
Tri-level home.
And then you got sick.
Nice size basement.
So that kind of nice has size put garage. Everything on hold.
Yeah, but it hasn't slowed me up that much. So.
So in the next coming days, weeks, Jake bought a bunch of inventory that we'll be hauling into our house.
That's the next video.
And that will be our next video, so stay tuned.
Tomorrow.
Love you, and
like, share, sub.
Thanks
sandwich.
For staying with us on all of our crazy adventures.
Appreciate all the love, people. Thank you.
Bye!